Hey everybody, Jay here. Welcome back to the channel. Yes, we are finally back out in the woods. Today's video is going to be a two-part video. We're going to do some trail maintenance and cutting up the trees you saw in a video or two ago. And also, we're going to talk about how to stay cool working out in the woods. So yeah, let's go ahead and get right into it. Folks, Jay here. Welcome back. It is a beautiful, what day is it? Today is June 30th. It is very hot. It's almost 90 something degrees. I think it's 95 out. Humidity is decently high. We're going to work for a little bit out here in the woods. We're going to clean up our trail. But before we get to that, I want to talk about how to stay cool working in the woods. First thing is hydrate. You need to hydrate 24 hours prior. Your body is like a sponge, but it's not instant. Your body takes about 24 hours to get and absorb and keep all that water. You should be peeing crystal clear before you even decide to go out into the woods. If you wake up in the morning and it's completely yellow, you're already past the point of you're not dehydrated, but it's gonna be a long way to go to keep up. So make sure you hydrate about 24 hours before you plan on going out. So that's tip number one. Tip number two about being in the woods, get out of here early, and if you can, get out here before the sun comes up. This just so happens to be a part of the forest here, which now that we've cleared, the sun is now coming in. But if you can get out here and work in the shade, that would be a good tip if you're working out in the woods. I know a lot of my channels, a lot of my people do firewood and trail maintenance and whatnot. So I have the opportunity to work, so I have to take it. So I can't really dictate the weather. I have baby coverage, so I am free to roam today. So that is tip number two. If you can get out early and beat the sun and work in the shade, that would be the best thing. Tip number three, wear plenty of sunscreen. I have sunscreen in the bag. I've already applied it. Also, two, get yourself a neck gaiter and wet it. If you wet this neck gaiter, it's going to feel a lot cooler on the back of your neck. It'll also keep the sun from roasting the back of your neck. Depending on which way I'm facing, I usually have my hat backwards and this gaiter up if I'm working with the sun behind me. Or if the sun's in front of me, I'll kind of have it right under my chin here. But keep this wet. That will help keep you cool. So I keep a bucket of water in the four-wheelers where I can constantly wet this and drip it over. It will make a world of difference on your neck and your vertebrae here. If you have something cold resting on your neck, that will definitely help. So that's the next tip. Next tip, as tempting as it is, leave your shirt on. This is a UV shirt. This is like an Under Armour. I don't know what you want to call it, but it is not. You don't want to wear cotton. That saying, cotton kills. Cotton holds moisture. You don't want that. So you want to wear one of these like active wear shirts, these Under Armour shirts, something that isn't 100% cotton, because you're going to sweat your you know what off if you wear cotton. So make sure you wear light colors too. Don't be wearing blacks out here. Wear whites, blues, you know, stuff, colors that will reflect the heat, not absorb it. So that's my next tip for staying cool here out in the woods. And finally, my last tip is if you can avoid it, do it, but take plenty of rest. Get a shade break. Keep an eye out on where the sun is. If you see a cloud approaching, say, okay, I'm gonna work until that cloud comes and then I'm gonna take a break. If I spin you guys around here, it's shaded behind the four-wheeler, so that's gonna be my watering spot. When I take a break, I'm gonna get out of the sun. But as you can see, speak of the devil, we have a few clouds passing by, and what a difference a single cloud makes. So yeah. Without further ado, I hope you enjoyed those tips to stay cool out in the woods. That's what I've done over the years and it's helped. There's plenty more, but the main thing is hydrate prior and during and after. Once you get in the house, your body is not done recovering. You need to hydrate. You need to basically call it detox off of that, you know, that sun strain. So you don't want to get heat strokes. Be safe out here. We're going to just keep rolling this video. I invite you guys to stick around. We're going to do some forestry. We're going to run the chainsaws here, but yes, the main beginning part of this video was how to stay cool in the heat working out in the woods. So yes, thank you guys for watching. I appreciate it. After this, I'm just gonna roll some footage of me bucking up all these small trees and we're clearing up our trail. So I invite you to stick around. It should be fun. But if you guys decide to leave, thank you for watching. I appreciate it, and we will see you out in the woods.